Hey everyone, it's Mila here, and today I want to give a short introduction to frame data and why you should give a fuck if you plan to improve quickly in Tekken 7. For those who are not familiar with it, first I want to clarify what is frame data. So basically, Tekken 7 runs normally in 60 frames per second. So this means that every second you have 60 consecutive frames or 60 consecutive pictures. So if a game runs with 60 frames per second, this means 1 second has 1000 milliseconds divided by 60. So one frame is 16.66 milliseconds. So let's say for example we want to analyze some specific moves of lore. A lot of people online spam Dragon Tales and you want to know the properties of this move. So here we have down back 4, which is Dragon Tail. It hits low. If it hits you, it knocks you down. If you spam a move and the Dragon Tail hits you, it is a counter hit, it will knock down you as well. Dragon Tail is doing 27 damage to you and it has 24 frames. It needs 24 frames until it's executed from the point where your opponent inputs down back 4. So from the moment where your opponent presses down back 4 until it hits you, it takes 400 milliseconds. So offline it shouldn't be a problem to block this move always 100%. Online it can be a problem. But this knowledge is not the reason why frame data is important. The reason why you should give a fuck about frame data and why it's important is this number. It gives you information at how much or at how many frames disadvantage your opponent is if you block a move. So in case of Dragon Tails, your opponent, if you block Dragon Tail, is at a disadvantage of minus 37 frames. So what's the easiest way to make use of this frame data and how can you use it to improve your playstyle effectively? So let's go into practice mode for that and let's assume I'm playing online against, let's say, Kasumi. So now we're in practice mode. So let's assume you're playing against an opponent who spams a specific move or you have problems countering a specific move. In our case, we want to practice it on, or I want to demonstrate it on Kasumi. Let's say you play against the Kasumi online and she always throws this move at you and you don't know what you have to do or how you can counter it. So first of all, you want to remember that move. After the match is done, you're going into practice mode and going to move list and you want to look for that move. In our case, it's the Thunder Punch combo. Okay, now we have the notation of this move. Now we're going to this site or to any site who has the frame data. Go to Kasumi and look for that notation. In our case it was square and triangle together, which is 1 plus 2. So we are looking for 1 plus 2, which is here, which is this move. So it has an animation time of 12 frames and if you block it, your opponent Kasumi is at a 14 frame disadvantage. So now that we know that your opponent's Kasumi is at a 14 frame disadvantage, if you block 1 plus 2, you can check out what punishes your character has. In the case of Lily, I know that Lily doesn't have a 14 frame launch punisher, so the options I can use to punish it, well, my best options would be using 1-2, which is a 10 frame punisher, 2-4, which is also a 10 frame punisher, and I could also use 1 plus 2, which is a 12 frame punisher. So let's demonstrate it. So this is the 1-2 punisher, which is also Lily's fastest punisher, and I think every character has the 1-2-10 frame punish. So of course 1 plus 2 in this case is better. It knocks my opponent down. I have a pretty good Oki for a 12 frame punish. And yeah, it also deals more damage. So remember, if you don't know what you have to do or how to counter a specific hit your opponent is spamming online, always remember this move. That's step 1. Step 2, go into practice mode and look for the notation. Step 3, open the frame data table and check the move for its properties and how much of a disadvantage your opponent is if you block it. Last but not least, step 4, you want to check your character's punishes and what's the best move to punish the specific move of your opponent. And of course it takes some time to learn this, but over time you will remember and know more and more moves, and on the long run it will really improve your playstyle. If you want to really get to the highest ranks, there's no way around it. You have to use frame data. So stay tuned for more.